Hey, what is up, all my Mussel memories, members? I don't know. I'm gonna work on a tag, figure out what I want to call you guys. But today, very exciting. First, pretty much real video. Today, I'm gonna bring you guys all about my soccer training, what a typical day looks like, a training day looks like for me. So we're gonna be working on some individual work by myself and whatnot. So I want to explain, you know, some simple tricks and drills that I do and how I make them, instead of being so basic, make them more efficient and make you work harder and make you think more game-like in like game-like situations. Now guys, another thing that's very important to, you know, a lot of soccer players, a lot of control work and honestly just fun, having fun with this game. Which a lot of people miss, you know, people think, you know, we're always putting in all this work and not enjoying the game. I enjoy it. I love working hard, and I love putting that extra effort in than anyone else to make myself better and to stand out on the field. But you can always have fun with it, and I think that people, what they miss is that they miss out on this little fun stuff, but that it actually helps you. So the big fun thing that many people miss is juggling. And why am I holding a tennis ball? This is why. Because listen, people juggle the soccer ball, and you know, when you're younger, everyone's like, oh, whoever has the highest, who can get the most, what's your record for most juggles? And that's great. You get 1,000, 2,000, you know, or if you can only do 10. Trust me, when I was younger, my goal was to get to 10. My travel coach wanted me to get to 10 juggles. It took me a couple months, and I finally did it. I felt so excited. But then it's always trying to do more, trying to do more. Now, it's simple for me to juggle both feet, use one foot, keep it close, pop it up in the air and touch. So there's many variations with juggling you can do to improve your touch. And this helps. This helps extremely from taking down crosses, from goalie punts, taking those down out the air. So the simple stuff of just juggling and getting the top of your foot, getting that touchdown is what's gonna help you even more into the game. So another trick that I've done, especially this season, I started doing it more, is grabbing a tennis ball. It could be a tennis ball, any type of soft ball or something. Don't go out getting a baseball and try to juggle that. It's going to kill your feet, or a lacrosse ball. But find something that's smaller than a soccer ball. So what I do is I'll do a couple hundred juggles with the soccer ball, using both feet, using only one foot. Using the left first, the right, the left, whatever. Maybe doing some tricks, whatever, if I'm feeling like having some fun. But then grab a tennis ball and work on juggling a tennis ball. I had coaches and players, my teammates and stuff, make fun of me for juggling this. I would do this before every game. It was like a ritual for me. But I'm telling you, this will help you because it makes you focus more on the ball and gets your mindset right for the game. A lot of people, you know, have, you know, certain rituals and stuff they do during a game. So I like you guys to try this out. Juggle a tennis ball. It's going to be rough at first. You're not going to be able to do too much at first. Trust me, I was terrible. I could maybe do 5, but I worked my way up and I was able to get 100 now. Working on more, but try juggling this because it's going to help you then. And then when you're done, go touch a soccer ball.
I'm OG, y'all new to the game. G, y'all new to the game. G.
there's basic drills like this cone drill. I'm going to show you in a second. That instead of just dribbling through each one, zigzagging in and out, there's different variances you can do. And I'm sure a lot of you soccer guys and girls have seen, you know, the multitude of drills you can do with this simple drill. But the one thing that I never really see people practicing, and for all your youngsters who are, you know, working your way up into the collegiate level, is we don't practice with our eyes off the ball. We train, when we're training, we're looking down. We're not looking, you know, around us and checking our surroundings, checking over our shoulders and everything. So this drill, what I try to do is I do a couple sets, looking down at the ball, getting my touch and rhythm down. And then the last couple sets, I'll go through it and I'll make sure I'm only looking at the cones in front of me. I'm not looking at the ball. And this helps with, you know, your peripheral vision and keeping the ball close and your touches close, but also helps in transition when you go into a game. Because in the collegiate level and even higher levels, you don't really look at the ball too much unless when you're passing, you're shooting, you're crossing, you're doing higher up tactical work. But when you're dribbling, you should not be looking down at the ball. That's only going to make it easier for a defender or anyone else in the other team to stop you. So it's important that we work on this stuff individually to get your mindset right and get you ready for the game. So when you go into the game and you receive that ball, your first instinct is not to look down and look at it. Your instinct is looking up, observing the field, and being ready for whatever comes your way. So let's get to it. So the next and final training drill that I do is pretty much I open it up then. So once we're done doing, you know, the juggle work, the small touches, and just, you know, getting the small touches and work done, I like to expand it and open it up. So the final drills that I'll do are basically longer distance dribbling and working on speed dribbling, which is very important for any striker, outside mid or center mid. Especially, you know, if you get on a counterattack or a breakaway or something, it's very important to know and keep your touch perfect when you're dribbling with speed. So these drills that I do, technically, they help a lot with speed dribbling and keeping it in control. That's the biggest issue with a lot of people when it comes to speed dribbling and opening up your legs and spring. The dribbling, you lose that touch and control. So this is going to help you with some dribbling stuff, especially for longer distances. And a lot of the stuff you can also do in variation too. So in a couple of videos, I'll start shortening and condensing all these drills. So it's specific needs. So I'll condense them if you guys want to see, you know, long distance dribbling drills that you want me to do for you. Small distance stuff and working on your little touches and control. So I'll condense it. Today I just wanted to show you guys, you know, what I typically do for an individual training session. This isn't always, I don't do the same exact drills. I'll mix it up. I just want to give you guys the three ideas of, you know, juggling first, doing small touch work and getting my feet moving in, and then finally opening it up and expanding it, and then really getting my legs working and getting the cardio in. So it's very important that, you know, you're not just going through the motions. You need to be in shape and keep your fitness up. So that's why I do these drills. It's a good cardio burner. Get your heart rate up, and you're also building your legs for the season. So you're not just going through the drills and being lackadaisical. So these drills will help you, and you'll be in shape and not even know it. That's the one thing that I've noticed about myself is, instead of just, you know, going out and running all the time, if I actually stay here, and I'll be on the field for around an hour to an hour and a half. So in that time, I'll pretty much run almost 5 miles. And that 5 miles is not just straight running 5 miles. I'm walking around like I am right now. But then I'm also doing some high intensity stuff too. So you don't really even notice how much you're running. So I'm going to show you this final drill, and then we'll be signing off. Here we go. Show it, no, I'll just hold my breath and keep it quiet. Every little